It's always a treat to sift through the vast array of statements Donald Trump has generously offered over the years. Even seasoned observers are raising their eyebrows at his latest oration. In a riveting Trump speech, Trump vows to cleanse the nation of communists, Marxists, fascists, and those left-wing thugs who, according to him, dwell like vermin within our borders. Now, don't take my word for it. This was just last Saturday, Veterans Day, in his campaign speech.
To you, that we will root out the communists, Marxists, fascists, and the radical left thugs that live like vermin within the confines of our country. The threat from outside forces is far less sinister, dangerous, and grave than the threat from within.
We've heard that before. In Mein Kampf, Adolf Hitler referred to Jews as vermin worthy of eradication, and Benito Mussolini would refer to his opponents as parasites and reptiles. So Donald Trump is following in some appalling and notorious footsteps of the most violent, dangerous men of the 20th century. But hold your horses, because Trump's linguistic masterclass doesn't end there. In the same breath, he regaled us with his take on the home invasion and brutal attack on Nancy Pelosi's husband.
Nancy Pelosi is a crazed lunatic. She's a lunatic. She is a crazed lunatic. What the hell was going on with her husband? Let's not ask. Let's not ask. I'll withdraw that statement. By the way, she's got a wall around her house. Obviously, in that case, it didn't work very well.
Classy as always. But wait, there's more. This glorification of violence, this call to abandon empathy, isn't just a Trump specialty. It's now a feature of the entire Republican Party. Take, for instance, Governor Ron DeSantis, who mocks former Governor Nikki Haley for expressing grief over the killing of George Floyd. According to DeSantis, we need leaders who fight the narrative, dismissing any acknowledgement of pain or injustice as left-wing capitulation.
Floyd riots were happening. I called out the National Guard. I said, I'm standing with police. She was tweeting that it needed to be personal and painful for every single person. And I'm thinking to myself, why does that need to be personal and painful for you or me? We had nothing to do with it. It just shows an example of her adopting this left-wing mindset and accepting the narrative. We need leaders who are going to fight the narrative.
The narrative, to be clear here, according to a jury's verdict, is that George Floyd was brutally unalived as onlookers begged the officer who pressed his knee into Floyd's neck for nearly 9 minutes to stop. But according to Governor DeSantis, any perceived pain for the public unaliving of an innocent American means you're somehow capitulating to the left wing and its agenda. Now, if you thought that the drama was confined to words, think again. In the hallowed halls of Congress, Republicans aren't just ready to brawl with Democrats, they're ready to brawl with each other. From elbowing incidents to embarrassing displays of machismo, the Trump effect has transformed the GOP into a party where violence isn't just accepted, it's deemed necessary. And as if that weren't enough, the GOP's latest performance in Congress involves infighting and a reliance on Democratic votes in an attempt to fund the government. And if you're a Republican right now, it's safe to say that this is all a little bit embarrassing. The party that once ousted a speaker for speaking or for seeking Democratic support is now electing hardliners who, surprise, also need Democratic votes to get anything done. But wait, there's a kicker. The last Republican House Speaker, Kevin McCarthy, is reportedly lashing out at those who cost him his job. And we're not talking metaphorical lashings. There's an alleged incident of McCarthy elbowing a fellow Republican in the kidney during an interview.
Why'd you elbow me in the back, Kevin?
Oh, no, I felt so bad.
Hey, Kevin, you got any guts?
Jerk.
Has he done that before?
No.
Huh. That's a new move.
I'm gonna go talk to him.
Hey, Kevin, why'd you go around me and elbow me in the back?
You got no guts. You did so. They sat there, and the reporter said it right there. What kind of chicken move is that? You're pathetic, man.
In summary, the Republican Party is showcasing a masterclass in internal discord, macho posturing, and a knack for relying on Democrats to keep things afloat. It's a spectacle that leaves us wondering, is this the new normal or just another fucking chapter in a never-ending saga of political theatrics? Stay tuned.